Baclofen pumps are a transformative therapy, but they don't come without risk. In this video, I'm going to be discussing the risks of baclofen overdose, withdrawal, and infection. If you or someone that you love suffers from severe spasticity and may have a baclofen pump or is considering one, then this video is for you. Don't go away because that learning starts right now. Learn about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between clinic visits, and it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. Today's video continues an ongoing discussion surrounding severe spasticity and the management using intrathecal baclofen pumps. I'll post a link up above and in the description down below of earlier videos from this series, where I talk about who's the right candidate for a pump, and what it means to go through an ITB test dose, and what it's like using a pump. This video is going to focus on risk, specifically three risks, that of baclofen overdose, baclofen withdrawal, and infection. Topic number one is baclofen overdose, when you receive too much intrathecal baclofen. Now, the first thing that we notice when there's an overdose is that you might be too floppy. The goal of the pump is to loosen stiff muscles, but if you're getting too much baclofen, that can be overboard. And so one of the first things we see is, hey doc, you took away too much tone, I'm feeling kind of floppy. And that's an easy one to fix, you just turn the pump back down. But overdose is a spectrum with, I'm a little floppy on one end. As you move through the spectrum, people can become sedated and confused. They can even ultimately lose consciousness and go into a coma. Severe risks include seizure and death. And I want to point out that this is a spectrum. I've been managing baclofen pumps now for almost a decade, and we don't see, thank God, death and coma. I just share that with you because I want you to understand the spectrum of what could happen. Now, a key takeaway when thinking about overdose is that it's almost always related to something that a human did, a procedure on the pump, whether it be a refill, or a reprogramming of the pump where maybe something wasn't put in correctly. And this is an important tip because someone with a baclofen pump who is getting really sedated and is really floppy, you wanna ask the question, when were you last in clinic? When did you last get refilled? When did you last have a program change? And this will typically clue you in. How do you manage baclofen overdose? Well, the first thing is you need to get to a provider right away. And so you're gonna call your provider who takes care of your pump, or you're gonna go to the emergency room. And typically the way that we deal with it is rather simple. We simply lower the dose. In a severe case, we can actually remove spinal fluid either through the pump or through a lumbar puncture. And when you pull the spinal fluid off, you're actually pulling off the baclofen, and then the effects of the overdose go away. Topic number two is intrathecal baclofen withdrawal. By way of quick review, the baclofen pump holds liquid baclofen, and this is surgically implanted inside you, with a catheter, a tube, also inside your body, connecting the pump to your back into the sac the spinal cord sits in. And this system delivers drug targeted to the spinal sac. It bathes the spinal cord in liquid baclofen. If there's a sudden abrupt arrest of that, if it suddenly stops delivering baclofen, the human being can go through a withdrawal. And you can have this happen because of a multitude of things. The pump could run empty. The catheter could become dislodged or cracked or break. Or the pump could malfunction. And the symptoms, the signs of withdrawal, again, are a spectrum. On one end, we can see just an increase in tone. They get stiff again. And if you move on the spectrum, we use a mnemonic. Intrathecal baclofen is the name of this therapy, and the mnemonic for withdrawal is also ITB, itchy, twitchy, bitchy. Let me explain what I mean. People who are going through withdrawal will start itching everywhere, even though they don't have a rash, and that's a tip-off. Twitchy is an off-color way of saying they have a return of their pathologic tone. They're having cramps, they're having spasms, they're having stiff limbs. And bitchy is an off-color way of reminding us that people going through withdrawal become unusually irritable. Now, again, going back to the spectrum, as you move forward and it gets more severe, it can ultimately include things like seizures, kidney failure, coma, and death. And again, I'm not saying that to you because this happens frequently, not at all. but I just want you to understand the spectrum. And I also want you to understand the seriousness of receiving a baclofen pump. If you develop itchy, twitchy, bitchy, you have to get yourself to the emergency department or to your provider. I actually provide my patients with oral baclofen, a bottle of oral baclofen that I want them to carry with me. Because if they start to have signs or symptoms of withdrawal, I want them to take oral baclofen and call me. Now, the third is infection. And infection is almost always surrounding the time of the surgical implant. Because it's a surgery, and so there can be perioperative infection. And this has everything to do with the skills of the surgeon and with wound healing and care afterwards. And so it's critically important, of course, to follow the instructions of the surgeon and make sure that you have the follow-up that you need to make sure that your incisions look okay. And when you have infection, this can become very serious because the baclofen pump connects into your central compartment. And so again, you don't want to blow it off and you need to go to see your provider immediately. I've just reviewed some scary stuff: baclofen overdose, withdrawal, and infection. I want to let you know that your baclofen provider should be very, very well equipped to deal with all of this. My team certainly is. We have handled situations very eloquently because we know what to look for and we educate our patients. And that's what I'm trying to do with you right now. I want you to be aware that this can happen so that you know what to look for. I want you to not be scared, and I want the knowledge to help you in making sure that you know what's going on and what you need to do and who you need to call. Once again, my name is Aaron Boster, and thank you for learning about multiple sclerosis and in this video, spasticity with me. This is part of a larger series that I've been doing on intrathecal baclofen pumps, and I hope that you found it helpful. If you like this video and you'd like to see more, please consider subscribing to the channel. And make sure to click that notifications button so you don't miss any of my future content. Until my next video, take care.